Today we are at Blizzard Beach, and it's quite a hot day, but the sun is not shining through the clouds at the moment. But it's still like the perfect day for being in the pool. Here we see one of the bigger rides, or slides, and there we almost had an accident. So Blizzard Beach is one of two water parks in the Walt Disney World theme park area. And if you didn't know it, it's situated... No, it's not in Dubai. This one is in Orlando. And let me tell you, many new theme parks have been popping up all over the world, like in China, in Dubai, but nothing can be compared to a Disney park. Disney makes it the way it should be. So this is where you exit the ride, or the slide. And if you look at the ground of this park, something that they don't have in Dubai, and it's actually wet ground, you walk in the wet. So that means when the sun is shining, you will not have to wear flip-flops, because you will not get burned. So this is the Lazy River, and it's really nice. It's not as good as in Atlantis Aquaventure, but it's still very nice. Let's have a look at people. That water is actually really cold. Imagine working here. What an inferno. All the rock work you see here is artificial, but it looks really nice and natural. If you ever come to this park and you wonder where can we sit because all the seats are taken, here's the place. Like being in a sandy beach in the middle of a jungle. I'm not gonna go on any slides or anything because, well, the point of this is more to take a walk around the park and have a look. And you can see there's water pouring, so that when you walk here, you will not burn your feet. It's details like that that makes the whole picture better. It's usually not that many leaves in the water as it is now, but you know. Here's a map. Let's take a look. And one other thing that I think the parks here in Florida, and especially Disney, does better than its competitors is, I mean, take a look. It's like walking around in a lush green garden, like a, almost like a jungle. The park is supposed to look like a, like if a snowstorm came over Florida. So at some places there are there's like fake snow to make it look like a snowy mountain with ski slopes. A while ago, I made a video about Legoland Water Park in Dubai, and some people think that I was overly negative about that park, but I mean, if you feel like it, take a look at one of the videos that are about Legoland Water Park in Dubai. Take a look at that. And then compare it to this. This is like a full theme park. Legoland Water Park in Dubai. It's more like a pool. It's more like a big pool with a couple of slides. Here's one of my favorite rides. It's like a race down. And all around the park there are beverage stations So you buy a refillable mug, and then you refill it with your beverage of choice. They had something like that in Dubai too, but I mean, in the Legoland water park. But I mean, you could only refill it in like one or two places in the entire park. And this park has been around for many years now. The water parks in Dubai have not. And we can also compare this to some water parks in Europe. I mean, there are a few really good ones in Europe, but you don't get the same weather. You don't get the same immersiveness. When it comes to theme parks, the Orlando area is the best place to be for theme parks and water parks. There is only one place that can compare to the parks in America, and that's Japan. In Japan they have Tokyo Disneyland, which is amazing. Like a whole new level of Disney entertainment, and they have Tokyo Disney Sea, which is the best theme park in the entire world. And why is it that? Is it because of the tallest and fastest roller coasters? No, it's because the parks. The park and the parks in Japan, they look amazing, they feel amazing, everything works, everything is clean. So anyway, this is a restaurant. Or it's more like a... Yeah, it's like a fast food place. To be honest, the food is not so great. It keeps you from going hungry. But not much more. Joffrey's Coffee Tea Company. Mini donuts. These mini donuts are really good. And they should be eaten with a white chocolate sauce that you can get with them. Amazingly good donuts. Small donuts. Let's go into one of the stores. So if you forget to pack your swimsuit or your sunglasses, towels, then you can buy it here. And you have your standard Disney candy selection. So how much is a towel? Let's check it out. $20 each. How do they feel? Oh, they feel very soft. They seem to have nice colors, and of course it's Disney themed. You can see the look of the towels. Here they have sandals. How much are sandals? Yeah, $30. Two t-shirts for $40. Here we have some non-Disney shirts. How much is that? $55. $24. You don't have to look like a super Disney fan if you don't want to. How much is a backpack? $50. Shorts, swimming shorts, bathing shorts. Yeah, $50. Flip-flops, $15. Star Wars themed for kids, they're also $15. So you can literally arrive here without anything but your clothes that you wear and money. And you can still enjoy the day. So one thing that I do recommend is to, of course, bring everything you need so you don't have to buy expensive stuff in the Disney stores. But also, buy the refillable mug. And if you don't like soda or you don't want to get your children into a sugar rush, you can always drink some free water from the water fountains. They have water fountain dispenser things here and there in the park. I'm not gonna go through the entire park, but a good portion of it. So these are restrooms and dressing rooms where you can change and do other stuff. They have lockers, plenty of lockers, where you can lock your things. So you can enter the park with, well, I wouldn't say luggage, of course, because the lockers are really small, but if you have valuables, you can keep them safe in the lockers. But I have to say, I have never kept my camera in the locker. I have never kept my wallet in the locker. Even my passport and all my most valuable things, I've had them in my bag, on my seat, and I have never experienced any crime whatsoever on Disney property here in Orlando. It's very safe, it's very organized, and it's huge. So this is the little kitty area. And you can smell the dirty diapers a mile away. It's like reeking of urine and dirty diapers. No, I'm just kidding. No dirty diaper smell at all. The smell in this park is sweet, sweet chlorine. They have cabanas if you're here with your family and you want to enjoy some, I wouldn't say private space, but if you want to have your own relax areas, you can enjoy the cabana. Although I have to remind everybody that the cabanas are quite expensive. Let's take a look here. So this is also a children's area, like smaller kids area, although it has some quite okay slides. There comes a kid.
Alright, let's get you to the bathroom.
And you can see on top of the mountain, high up, is one of the world's tallest water slides. And there are quite many water slides on top of this mountain, but I'm not gonna go up there. I'm too lazy to do that. I'm not gonna show you the entire place. Let's have a look at this. So there's plenty of areas for kids who like water slides but do not want to go on any slides that are very tall. A shower. So if you don't want to walk up the mountain, you can go on a ski lift. But there's quite a line to the ski lift, so I usually just walk up. But it's a fun thing to do if you... It's like a ride in a water park. Not thrilling, but still nice. You get a nice view from it. So, this slide I actually prefer to the taller one because you actually get some air time twice on this slide. But this is the tallest, the fastest, and the most thrilling experience here in the park. So, if you haven't done it, you should go. Thank you. opening hours for this park, I think, is something like 10 to 4 or 10 to 5. It kind of depends on what time of year you go. So here's the main pool area, the wave pool, and there is also a beach area, so you can experience a beach with clean water and sun. They have some drinks here, or yeah, you can order drinks. Drinks with your donuts. Well, that was the main areas of Disney's Blizzard Beach. The video has come to an end. I think I'm going into the water now. So if you like the video, maybe give it a thumbs up. If you don't like the video, give it a thumbs down. But if you watched it all this way, give it a thumbs up. Do it for Disney. And if you didn't like the video, you should watch it again. See ya.